It was a dark and stormy night. The wind was howling and the rain was pouring down heavily. In a small town, there was a house at the end of the street that had been abandoned for years. This house was known for its spooky and eerie appearance. It had become a popular spot for ghost stories and urban legends. However, no one dared to enter the house, as it was said to be cursed. On this particular night, the family living in the house next door had gone out for a weekend trip, leaving their 12-year-old son, Tim, home alone. Tim was excited about the idea of being home alone, as he would get to watch his favorite horror movies and eat junk food without any disturbance from his parents. As soon as his parents left, Tim locked all the doors and windows, turned off all the lights, and settled in front of the TV. He put on his favorite horror movie and was completely lost in it. Suddenly, he heard a loud bang coming from outside. He dismissed it as the wind and continued watching the movie. But after a few minutes, he heard the same sound again, this time even louder. Feeling a bit uneasy, Tim decided to check the source of the sound. He cautiously went to the window and looked outside, but he couldn't see anything due to the heavy rain. He shrugged it off and went back to his movie, trying to convince himself that it was just his imagination. Just when he was starting to relax, he heard the sound again, but this time it was coming from inside the house. Tim's heart started racing as he realized that he was not alone in the house. He got up from the couch and slowly made his way towards the source of the sound. As he walked through the dark hallway, he could feel someone's presence behind him. He turned around, but no one was there. Feeling scared, Tim ran back to the living room and locked the door. He then called his parents, but there was no network. He tried calling for help, but no one could hear him over the loud thunder. The power went out, and Tim was left in complete darkness. He could hear strange noises coming from all around the house. Terrified, Tim decided to go to his room and hide under the covers. But as he was about to leave the living room, he saw a figure standing in the corner. It was a tall man with pale skin and dark, sunken eyes. Tim froze in fear as the man slowly started moving towards him. He tried to scream, but no sound came out of his mouth. Just then, the man's face transformed into a horrifying smile, and he let out a blood-curdling laugh. Tim knew that he was in danger, and he had to escape. He ran towards the front door, but it wouldn't open. He then tried the windows, but they were all jammed. Realizing that he was trapped, Tim ran up to his room and locked the door behind him. He hid under his bed, but the man was not far behind. He could hear the man's footsteps getting closer and closer. Tim closed his eyes and prayed for this nightmare to end. The next morning, Tim's parents came back to find him, huddled in a corner of his room, trembling with fear. He told them about the man and the strange events of the previous night. His parents comforted him, thinking it was just his imagination and the storm that had scared him. But as they were leaving the house, they noticed a fresh handprint on the living room window. Tim's parents were shocked, as there was no way anyone could have entered or left the house. They quickly packed their bags and left, never to return to that house again. From that day on, Tim never wanted to be left home alone, and he never watched horror movies again. The experience of that night had scarred him for life, and he was grateful to be alive. As for the abandoned house, it remained a mystery, and no one ever dared to enter it again.